हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नमस्कार। बैंकिंग लोकपाल, बैंकिंग ओम्बड्समैन इज वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म विच यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट एंड इट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिड्रेसल सिस्टम ऑफ रिजॉल्विंग द कंप्लेंट्स ऑफ द पब्लिक एट लार्ज अगेंस्ट द बैंक्स, अगेंस्ट द NBFCs एक्सेट्रा। रिसेंटली रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया हैज इंटीग्रेटेड द एग्जिस्टिंग 3 ओम्बड्समैन स्कीम्स विच आर प्रिवेलेंट एंड इट हैज अप्लाइड It has come out with an integrated ombudsman scheme. Now, what is this scheme? What are its features? How you can use the help of this particular scheme? And what are the other nitty-gritties? Through this video, I am trying to put up all such points before you in a summarized manner. The first point which came in my mind was that, okay, why this scheme has come up? If you will see that Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi has launched this particular scheme on last 12th of November 2021 to be called as Reserve Bank Integrated Ombudsman Scheme. The purpose of this scheme is to integrate the existing 3 ombudsman scheme, as I already told you, and further very important point is to provide cost-free redressal of the customer complaints involving deficiency in services rendered by the entities regulated by RBI, if not resolved to the satisfaction of customer or not replied within 30 days by the regulated entity. So there comes a time period also that if your complaint is not resolved within 30 days or it is resolved but it is not resolved up to your satisfaction, then in that case, a particular person may approach to the integrated ombudsman scheme for seeking necessary resolution through Reserve Bank of India. Let me quickly tell you that which were the existing 3 ombudsman schemes prevalent in India. The Banking Ombudsman Scheme 2006, the Ombudsman Scheme for Non-Banking Finance Companies 2018, and the Ombudsman Scheme for Digital Transaction 2019. And all these 3 schemes now, my dear friends, are being merged into Integrated Ombudsman Scheme 2021. Now comes a very important point that, okay, which institutions are covered under the scheme, that is the Integrated Ombudsman Scheme, that if you are aggrieved against any particular action of the scheduled commercial banks, the regional rural banks, scheduled urban cooperative banks, other urban cooperative bank with deposits of rupees 50 crore and above, all deposit taking non-banking finance companies, NBFCs with assets rupees 100 crore and above, or non-bank system participant, then you can approach to the RBI through this particular integrated ombudsman scheme, under which there will be an ombudsman. This ombudsman will listen to, will see, will look into your query and will try to get a resolution for you from the relevant entity. If they could provide a resolution to your satisfaction, then this is the effort which can be developed through this particular integrated ombudsman scheme. Let me also tell you which institutions are not covered under this scheme. The urban cooperative banks with deposits of less than rupees 50 crore, NBFCs with assets of less than rupees 100 crore, housing finance companies are also beyond the ambit of this integrated ombudsman scheme. And there are core investment companies which are also beyond the ambit of this particular integrated ombudsman scheme. I can further say that the complaints which are pertaining to these institutions, if any, will continue to be handled by the consumer education and protection cell of RBI, or in the case of housing finance companies, by the National Housing Bank. Now, my dear friends, I am putting up before you what are the salient features of the scheme. These features are very important for us to note that it will now no longer be necessary for a complainant to identify under which scheme he she should file complaint with the ombudsman, because earlier there were 3 schemes prevalent. You need to choose that, okay, under which scheme you are applying. Now there is an integrated ombudsman scheme, so you have to straight away go click and file your complaint. This scheme defines the deficiency in the service as the ground of filing a complaint, with a specified list of exclusions. Therefore, the complaint would no longer be rejected simply on account of not covered under the grounds listed in the scheme. See, there is a definition which is used in the scheme called deficiency in service, and there could be various kind of deficiencies, like certain charges are applied against you, the interest is not charged properly, it is charged at a higher rate, certain additional interest has been charged, certain charges which are applied, you are not satisfied with those particular charges being applied to you. So all these particular things have been given in form of a deficiency in service in a larger category. So that any particular complaint which you want to file, which is eligible as per the scheme, could be filed by you. Further, the scheme has done away with the jurisdiction of each ombudsman office, because earlier, say if I was filing a complaint in a particular jurisdiction and there was a challenge over the jurisdiction by the ombudsman saying that, okay, you are not supposed to file this complaint at Delhi, you should file it at Jaipur. So that could be one problem area. Now that problem gets resolved because there is a one point connect RBI office Chandigarh. That will be the nodal office for this particular thing. They will further coordinate at local levels of different RBI regions. So from the point of view of customer, it is an improvement. A centralized receipt and processing center, as I said, has been set up by the RBI at Chandigarh for receipt and initial processing of physical and email complaints in any language. The responsibility of representing the regulated entity and furnishing information in respect of complaints filed by the customer against the regulated entity would be that of principal nodal officer in the rank of a general manager in public sector bank or equivalent. A very important point, sir. When you file a complaint to this integrated ombudsman scheme, then RBI would coordinate, this integrated ombudsman would coordinate with the bank. And this scheme is saying that the general manager rank level officer would be responsible for coordinating with the RBI. So your complaint gets attention that way because it is filed with the general manager level officer of the bank or NBFC. The regulated entity will not have the right to appeal in case where the award is issued by the ombudsman against it for not furnishing satisfactory and timely information or document. See, what happens in the scheme, when you file a complaint and say some award is allotted in your favor or award is issued in your favor by the ombudsman. This award, when it is issued in your favor, considering the fact that the relevant specified entity has not replied, the regulated entity has not replied to the RBI or has not provided the timely information to the RBI, that is the ombudsman, then against that award, that regulated entity will be barred from filing an appeal. So this is one interesting fact which is coming in this particular scheme's features. Now let me bring before you certain filing related points which are important for you to note for the purpose of this integrated ombudsman scheme, that the filing of complaint under the scheme will continue to happen as it was happening in past to this particular link, that is https://cms.rbi.org.in. The complaints can also be filed through the dedicated email or sent in physical mode too. Now, where you can send, if you want, you can send it by registered post, courier, etc. to the centralized receipt and processing center, which is set up by RBI, 4th floor, sector 17, Chandigarh, 160017 is the pin code. Additionally, a contact center with a toll-free number is also being provided for this integrated ombudsman scheme, that is 1-448, wherein you can call between 9:30 to 5:15 PM, and this will be operational in 8 different regional languages in addition to Hindi and English. So these 8 languages will be like Bengali, Gujarati, Kannada, Oriya, Malayalam, Marathi, Tamil and Telugu, and RBI is saying that we will enhance the scope of these particular languages in further also. This contact center, my dear friend, will also provide information clarification regarding the alternate grievance redress mechanism of the RBI to guide the complainants in filing of a complaint. So these are the filing related points which you need to take care about. Now I wish to attract your attention on a very important point or a slide: when a complaint shall not be maintainable. You need to take care about that, okay, your complaint, if it falls into following categories, then your complaint would not be maintainable in this integrated ombudsman portal. You would be certainly interested in knowing them. No complaint for deficiency in service shall lie under the scheme in the matters which are involving commercial judgment, commercial decision of the regulated entity. Say, for example, you are denied with a loan. Then this is a commercial decision of the bank that, okay, they don't think that your loan is a fit case for this particular disbursement from their side, sanction from their side. So this is a commercial decision which prima facie can't be subject matter of this redressal mechanism. a dispute between a vendor and a regulated entity relating to outsourcing contract. So say if there is a regulated entity and there is a vendor who is giving some outsourcing contract, taking some services are taken by a regulated entity from that particular agency, then any dispute between these two entities would not be subject matter of this integrated ombudsman scheme. A grievance not addressed to the ombudsman directly. Say if you are marking a confirmation copy, CC to the ombudsman, then this is also not subject matter of this integrated ombudsman scheme. The general grievances against the management or executive of a regulated entity would also not form part of this integrated ombudsman scheme. A dispute in which action is initiated by a regulated entity in compliance with the orders of the statutory or law enforcing authority would also not be subject matter of complaint before this integrated ombudsman scheme. A service not within the regulatory purview of the RBI naturally would be out of the scope of this scheme. A dispute between regulated entities, say between two regulated entities, if there is a dispute, that would also not be eligible for being filed before this ombudsman scheme. And a dispute which is involving employer-employee relationship of a regulated entity would also not fall to this particular integrated ombudsman scheme. Now let me also tell you that when a complaint shall not lie, that is the eligibility of the complaint would not arise if the following conditions are not satisfied. A very important point to be noted, a complaint under the scheme shall not lie unless the complainant had before making a complaint under the scheme made a written complaint to the regulated entity concerned. So first, where you have to approach to regulated entity. If they don't resolve your query, they don't resolve your complaint, then you are entitled to avail the benefit of this platform. So you have to first reach out to the regulated entity. Now, what is a regulated entity? A bank or an NBFC, as the case may be. The complaint was rejected wholly or partly by the regulated entity, and the complainant is not satisfied with the reply, or the complainant had not received any reply within 30 days after the regulated entity received the complaint. So either you applied, they replied, that is regulated entity has replied, but you are not satisfied with their reply, or you have applied with your complaint to the regulated entity, say you have filed a complaint to the bank, and the bank, even after 30 days of receipt of your complaint, has not responded to you. And the third condition is that the complaint is made to the ombudsman within 1 year after the complainant had received the reply from the regulated entity, and where no reply is received within 1 year and 30 days from the date of complaint. So the important point is that an outer time limit is also drawn here. Say if you are not satisfied with the reply which is received from the regulated entity, then within 1 year from the date of receipt of reply, you can reach out to the integrated ombudsman cell or the scheme. And where you have applied but they have not replied, that is the regulated entity has not replied, then you have a time limit of reaching out to this integrated ombudsman scheme or portal, 1 year, 30 days. So this is the outer time limit, which is also important for you to be known. Certain other points are also there, that when a complaint shall not lie, the complaint is not in respect of same cause of action which is already pending before an ombudsman, or settled or dealt with on merits by an ombudsman, whether or not the received from the same complainant or along with one or more complainants or one or more of the parties concerned, which is pending before court, tribunal, arbitrator or any other forum or authority, or settled or dealt with on merits by any court, tribunal, arbitrator or any other forum. So you need not to apply twice. Once you have reached out to court, tribunal, arbitrator, you are also at the same time applying to this particular ombudsman. Then both the remedies are not possible. This is the message which is there through this particular eligibility criteria. Certain other criteria are also there, like the complaint is not abusive, frivolous or vexatious in the nature. The complaint to the regulated entity was made before the expiry of period of limitation, which is prescribed under Limitation Act 1963 for the relevant claim. And the complainant provides complete information as specified in Clause 11 of the scheme. So you have to also provide all the information, otherwise your complaint will not be maintainable. The complaint is lodged by the complainant personally or through an authorized representative other than advocate, unless advocate is aggrieved person. Further, I would take you through the procedure of complaint handling. What is the procedure of complaint handling, my dear friends? In this integrated ombudsman scheme, number one, your initial scrutiny of complaints would take place. Then RBI, naturally, the ombudsman will have the power to call the information either from you if any further clarification required or from the banking or financial institution. Then it will finally resolve, that is, the resolution of complaint will take place. And if RBI deems fit, that is, the ombudsman deems fit, then an award by the ombudsman will be granted in the favor of the complainant. One very important point which you should also note is that there may be certain grounds of rejection of complaint. I'm just putting up before you the highlight of it. The rejection of a complaint may be made by the deputy ombudsman or ombudsman. They may reject a complaint at any stage if it appears that complaint made is not maintainable under clause 10. See the criteria which I have mentioned to you. Those criteria are important if your complaint files falls into any of those particular conditions, then your complaint can be rejected, or it is in the nature of offering suggestion, like you are suggesting something, or you are seeking certain guidance, or you are asking them to give certain explanation. Then in these cases, the complaint which is made by you may be rejected by the integrated ombudsman also. So one has to be careful about them. There are certain other criteria also, my dear friend, which I have not covered here. Yet, I have given you a link along with this particular video through which you can go through the complete scheme. And the reading of the complete scheme would make you understand that, okay, how this particular scheme will be operationalized as and when a complaint will be filed by the customer. Finally, my dear friends, I must say that, yes, it has been a long video that way to understand the concept, but because this is a customer-centric issue. This is an issue where the financial literacy is required. In India, there has been some practices which are followed maybe by banks or maybe by NBFCs which are not easily digestible to the customers. So therein, if you don't find their practices digestible, you have a complaint, this scheme says that, okay, you should first approach to that relevant entity. If they give you a solution, it is well and good. If they don't give, then you should have a redressal mechanism. And the integrated ombudsman scheme is a good effort, in my opinion, in that direction, because it is a centralized thing. You need not to go here and there again and again. It is a one-centric thing. So we must avail the benefit of it if required for our benefit. So my dear friends, I think that you will find this particular video, or you must have found this video useful to you. But your comments and suggestions are most welcome. Thank you very much for being with me. Wishing you all the best. Jai Hind.